Rascals. Rachel is constantly confounding society's outdated sexist attitudes. First on Countdown by being a young, attractive woman who's also excellent at maths, and then on Strictly by being a young, attractive woman who's shit at dancing. Rachel, are there any maths, like, party tricks that you can do? Because people know you're great at maths, so do people ever go, right, can you do something impressive?
Well, people do introduce me at parties saying I'm a mathematician, and I recently was at a party with loads of Americans and just realised quite how weird my job is. I think my party trick is just making people look confused and step away. Because you start by saying you're a mathematician, and then it's on TV, and then it's on a comedy show, and then I do times, tables, to numbers. And at this point, I lose the room. So, yeah. Exactly. Sean, help me out. Come on, sound effect.
Hit the button.
He's not doing it. He's leaving me hanging.
You're right. Some things you can't help.
Rachel says she loves a man who's good at working out. Well, Rachel, if you mean maths, I'm not your man. But if you mean going down the gym and pumping iron, then I'm still not your man. Rachel, what advice would you give to any wannabe mathematicians watching?
Well, there's loads of stuff you can study to do with maths that's not just numbers. So recently I went to Everton's training ground to see how they use maths there to make the players better.
Well, like score more goals than the other team.
Or like get your heart rate up and just lots of different things that they're measuring. And someone else that
Sorry, Everton invited you to their changing room to watch them measure stuff.
Not their changing room, but their training ground.
Their training ground. So what were they measuring?
What technology. They were measuring heart rate.
Do you mean like algorithms?
No.
Not you. Just trying to meet you halfway.
Where would we be without Rachel Riley? I guess helping a drunk Carol Vorderman out of her mobility scooter. If you're watching, Carol, oh, she'll be passed out by this hour. Now, a lot of kids have got exams coming up soon. Have you got any tips for maths revision?
Not really. I used to watch Disney films while I was doing my maths revision. It just makes it a bit more fun. Doesn't help with the revision, but it worked for me.
I struggled with the Disney films.
Rachel is a bona fide British genius. If she gets any more intelligent next series, she's going to be played by Eddie Redmayne. Rachel worked hard to overcome the legacy of her predecessor, but let's face it, no one's going to forget Karen Venderman in a hurry. Rachel is a role model for any intelligent, ambitious young woman who wants to have a career, standing next to a row of jumbled-up letters. Rachel, if you had to be stranded on a desert island with either me, Susie, Lee or Sean, who would you go with?
Well, Susie would be quite good. She's quite strong. She's good at arm wrestling. But I think I'd go for someone taller that could kind of reach the coconut, so maybe one of the guys. I don't know Lee well enough. I think Sean...
You'd have to know me well to know how tall I am.
You want someone tall enough to reach the
coconuts? Reach the coconuts, I think.
Not tiny Jimmy. Little Jimmy Carr.
You can't reach the coconuts.
John can. John can.
Oh, Jimmy, do you want me to get you a coconut?
Oh, you know, because you didn't come, because Rachel didn't invite you.
And she doesn't even know me very well.
I think Sean will be the first one to turn to cannibalism. So
Sean wouldn't even wait for you to be shipwrecked for that.
So yeah, I'd pick you, Jimmy. I think you'd probably be the first one to be able to call a helicopter. And chances are, if we've gone to a desert island, we might be there for tax purposes. So it might be somewhere nice.
It's a good point, well made.
Rachel says one of the things she can't live without is earplugs. Well, that's years of Susie Dent's anecdotes for you. Rachel, who's your weirdest crush?
There is one person, actually. He's a little bit older than me. He's the comedian slash presenter, He's got this show where comedians come on and sometimes there's a music act and other celebrities. And he's got two dogs. And I asked my friends, and because I didn't think it was a weird crush, but they said it definitely was, because everyone knows he's gay. Graham Norton.
In 2010, Rachel appeared on a documentary called Kids Don't Count, which asked why Britain's children are failing when it comes to maths. Turns out it's because it's boring.
You didn't watch it, clearly.
No one did, Rachel. Rachel, you nearly did a master's degree in concrete. Why?
Well, it sounded interesting. Obviously. It involves building stuff and maths. And then if I need to get rid of some bodies somewhere in the future, I'll know how.
Rachel, now you used to work in a bank. How does that compare to working on Countdown?
When I worked at the bank, it was when the markets crashed. So, you know, serious stuff, people were made homeless. But the worst thing that can happen here is sometimes when Countdown's on the board, I accidentally cover up the first O with my head and then get, you know, screen grabbed.
Now, you're from Essex, Rachel.
Yeah.
Joey is, I mean, from Essex. He's Mr. Essex. Would you ever consider going on TOWIE?
Well, I think the one thing that everyone would agree is missing from TOWIE is the numbers round. It's more of a language, you know, programme at the moment, isn't it? Once you've got the vocab, you can kind of work out what's going on most of the time.
Where about in Essex are you from?
South End, mate.
Oh, yeah.
She's like the one that got away.
I think that's quite a good chat-up technique. Yeah. Just ask someone where they're from, and then they say, you go, really?
Rachel, if the Countdown studio was on fire and you could save me or Sean or John, who would you save?
Well, I think in that scenario, Sean probably started the fire.
That is a safe bet, yeah?
John's probably worked out the fire escapes and he's got his best route. But I could use your teeth as kind of a beacon, like a torch.
So, Rachel, looking around you here, do you think any of us have got the potential to be a maths genius?
Well, typically, proper maths geniuses, they're quite young. They're often guys. They're often loners. Often not very good social skills.
So, John.
I wonder where this is going.
So, no, definitely no one around here.
If you weren't on Countdown, what would be your perfect job?
Well, I love animals, so I'd be doing something with animals, probably cats or dogs. I mean, there's a place in Southend. There's a place. There's a place in Southend, a cat hotel that my cats have gone to, called the Pussy Palace.
Get a bigger horn!
There's only so much in there. You know what I mean?
There's a place called the what, sorry?
The Pussy Palace.
And you'd like to work at the Pussy Palace? Rachel's got a first in quantum mechanics from Oxford University, and now she does the numbers on Countdown. It's like using the Large Hadron Collider to heat up soup. Rachel, you hosted a show recently about improving your memory. Have you got any tips for us on how we could improve our memories?
Yeah, so the visual memory is a lot stronger than any other kind of memory. So if you wanted to remember someone's name, say Jimmy, for example,
right,
you could think of something memorable to you. So I'd go maybe Jimmy Riddle, Cockney rhyming slang. So imagine you having a wee, and then you imagine something really prominent about their face that stands out. So you look a little bit like a vampire.
I'm not sure we can all agree on that.
So you could be dressed up as a vampire, having a wee, and then I'd remember your name.
I think what you're having there is a sexual fantasy.
Doesn't work with everyone, because Kathy Burke. Burke's a really rude word in Cockney rhyming slang, so you shouldn't go there.
Is it?
Berkeley Hunt.
Oh, is that what it's from?
Yeah.
And what does that rhyme with?
OK, Rachel, you recently hosted a show about improving your memory. Have you got any tips on how we could improve our memory? Rachel spends every day working out basic math sums and talking to Nick Hewer. She's living proof that blondes don't have more fun. Were you bad at anything at school?
I was good at sport, but I was with, like, the fat kids for things like high jump, so it was always, like, the fat kids that couldn't run and me. And then they introduced bending. When I was at school, they just introduced this thing where they had to check how well you could bend, and I couldn't...
Oh, no, no.
Rachel, could you just bend over for us? We've just got to check it. Rachel thinks about numbers 24/7, and sometimes the other numbers as well. Rachel, do you ever get Countdown fans asking you to help them with their maths problems?
Yeah, sometimes. I mean, mostly it's just gibberish. But occasionally you get sent a really good maths problem, so I took one to the park last week. Had a good go on that.
Maths problem means what I think it means, right?
Sorry, I'm really nervous. I'm a bit of a Bill Bailey stalker tonight, so I just want to get it out there early, but I've seen him, like, 5 or 6 times live, and I'm just a bit nervous tonight.
OK,
I've got a few maths problems I need to go through.
You've got a bit of a crush on Bill?
Well, not I'm just more love, you know. There was a headline once that, I'm signal?
Oh, my God, you've got it so bad. What is your secret, Bill? What's going on?
It's just two twats.
Got grade 6 clarinet. I mean,
I think if Rachel was found peering into your kitchen window, you would still be the one that got arrested.
Rachel appeared on a Channel 4 Dispatches documentary asking why Britain's children are failing when it comes to maths. Turns out they're a bit thick. Now, Rachel, you work with 3 Countdown hosts.
Yeah.
You work with Jeff Sterling, Nick Hewer, and me. Who is your favourite?
Well, you've all got your own different qualities. You're very different people. I mean,
Moving on. What do you mean we've got our own?
Well, Nick, you know, informs us about poetry and dead people. And you're good with the humour. But Jeff Sterling got me tickets to the Champions League final with Man United against Barcelona. So, my dad actually said it was worth having kids after all when I took him to that game.
What's your worst habit, Rachel?
Oh, I'm quite unprofessional at work. It's quite.
Yeah, I've noticed that. Yeah.
Yeah. I often crack up when Nick says something that he doesn't mean to say. So at the end of our series last year, we'd finished the quarterfinals, and he said, "See you on Monday for a semi." Didn't handle that very well.
I thought we did the late night version. Now, Rachel, if you go out with friends for dinner, do they always expect you to divide the bill?
On my birthday last year, my friend decided it was a treat for me, so I didn't have to divide the bill, but we accidentally left a 25-cent tip, because it turns out no-one else can do maths drunk.
Have you ever done Countdown drunk?
When Nick moved for filming, so we were actually filming on a Sunday, and the night before, one of my best friends got married, so I probably was still a little bit drunk from the night before. But I could still do the numbers, it was fine.
Sure. Now, what first captivated you about the world of maths?
Well, it brought me loads of friends and just that cool factor.
I think you may be delusional.
I just liked it. I was good at it.
It's very telling that my wife loves maths because she said there's only one right answer. You know what I mean?
There's only one right... Well, there's lots of ways to get to the same answer.
Yeah, but the answer is one. I like to interpret things in a different, you know, sort of... I may have burnt the shed down. Or I may have created a bigger garden.
Rachel joined Countdown in January 2009 after Carol Vorderman sadly broke her leg and had to be shot and melted down for glue. Rachel, present company accepted, who's your idol? Who do you most look up to?
Well, actually, I'd go for Susie. I think Susie's awesome. She's a working mum. She knows every word imaginable except anything vaguely rude. She's gorgeous and she's really good at arm wrestling.
You're good at arm wrestling?
I love arm wrestling.
Well, let's get the guns out.
Maybe later. You've missed out a mole there.
Oh.
I've seen you wrestle Nick Hewer and Jeff Stelling.
What, at the same time?
It sounds like you walked in on something and they made up an excuse. And you... Rachel Riley appeared on Strictly, where she proved she's not only nearly as clever as Stephen Hawking, she's almost as good at dancing. Rachel, last time Bill Bailey was on the show, you revealed that you've actually got a bit of a crush on Bill. Do you think you'll be able to sort of keep your emotions in check this evening?
Well, I kind of lost the power of speech last time Bill was on. And as soon as my producer found out he was on again, he actually sent me an email and told me not to disgrace or embarrass myself again. And my mum actually got me Bill tickets for my birthday, so I've got an incentive not to get a restraining order before October.
You've got tickets to see Bill in October?
Yeah, I've
in a theatre or just in my house? Well, I'll be there.
It's weird because if you saw both their pictures like on the telly and said which one's stalking which,
a recording of Countdown once had to be stopped when someone let off a stink bomb in the studio. At least that's what Rachel would have us believe. Rachel, how do mathematicians like to have a good time?
Well, thinking back to the mathematicians at uni, I mean, the standard stuff like drinking, but there was one guy that used to, he was a mathematician, he used to just wake up with no trousers on and, like, a pinboard over his bits.
A pinboard?
Yeah, he just used to do it all the time, but...
I think you bring out the worst in men.
Well, he also liked doing Rubik's Cubes really quickly and could memorise pi to I don't know how many places. You know, the record for that is 22,514 decimal places of pi.
Yes, I did know that. I think everyone knew that.
Ah, can I ask a question? What is the benefit of knowing pi to that?
There isn't.
Don't they use it for random number generation?
Well, a computer might use it, but why would a person need to recall 22,514 digits?
What if there was a power cut and all the computers were dead? Yeah. Think of these things.
OK, and the prize...